Good morning. In the previous lecture, we completed the first unit, algorithm and flowchart for various tasks, various programs, problems. The next unit is about control statements. Second unit from Fortran, control statements. The first article is first article, character set of Fortran. Now let us see what is meaning of character set of Fortran. Meaning of character set of Fortran is what characters are used in Fortran language. Set of the characters which are allowed to use in Fortran language is known as character set of Fortran. Now what characters are allowed to used in Fortran language? The alphabets A through Z. All the alphabets, 16 alphabets, A through Z, A, B, C, D, etc. up to Z are allowed to use. Then the numerals, 0 through 9, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. up to 9 are also allowed to use in Fortran language. And the special symbols plus, minus, the asterisk for product, slash, comma, dot, bracket, the quote or quotation mark, dollar, etc., etc. Various special symbols can also be used as Fortran characters. So, what is character set of Fortran? Character set of Fortran consists of all the alphabets. You are allowed to use the alphabets, English alphabets. Numerals 0 through 9, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 9 are also allowed to use in Fortran. And the symbols, symbol for addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, comma, decimal point or full stop, the simple bracket, single quotation mark, dollar, etc., etc. So many special symbols are there. We can also use these special symbols. So, character set of Fortran consists of all the English alphabets, all the numerals 0 through 9, of course, in English, and the various symbols. All these together form a character set of Fortran. This is about the first article. Very simple and very small article. Character set of Fortran. Character set of Fortran means that what characters you are allowed to use in Fortran. And we are allowed to use all English alphabets. We are allowed to use English numerals 0 through 9. We are also allowed to use various special symbols. All these together form the character set of Fortran. So whenever somebody asks you, what is character set of Fortran? Your answer will be, character set of Fortran consists of all the English alphabets A to Z, the numerals in English 0 through 9, and various special symbols. These all together give us character set of Fortran. This is about the first article from second unit, control statements. Okay, now let us move to the next article. Constants. Second article is constants in Fortran. To define constant, it is a physical quantity. It is an invariable physical quantity. The character which represents the character which represent, it may be a single character, it may be string of characters, group of characters, which represents invariable value, the value which is not going to vary. Such a value is known as a constant. Now, when we talk of constants in Fortran, basically there are two categories of constants. So, when you are talking about constants in Fortran, when we talk of constants in Fortran, basically there are two categories of constants. This category is character constant, this category is numeric constant. Character constants are also known as string constants. Numeric constants are number constants. Numerals are used to represent numeric constants. We shall start with numeric constants. There are again various types of numeric constants. After completing the discussion of various types of numeric constants, we shall go for character constant. So, let us come to numeric constants. Let me write this as numeric constants. We are starting with numeric constants. Numbers are used to represent. Numerals are used to represent numeric constants. Numbers 0 through 9. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 9. Any of these numerals are used to represent the constants which are known as numeric constants. Numeric constants are further divided into two categories. The first category is integers or fixed point numbers or numerals. First category of numeric constants is integers or fixed point numbers or numerals. Second category of numeric constants is real constants or फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट कॉन्स्टेंट्स, रियल कॉन्स्टेंट्स और फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट कॉन्स्टेंट्स. सो व्हाट वी डू, वी शैल फर्स्ट स्टडी इंटेजर्स और फिक्स्ड पॉइंट कॉन्स्टेंट्स, फिक्स्ड पॉइंट नंबर्स, एंड आफ्टर दैट वी शैल गो फॉर द रियल कॉन्स्टेंट्स और फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट कॉन्स्टेंट्स. सो लेट मी स्टार्ट विथ इंटेजर्स और फिक्स्ड पॉइंट नंबर्स. First category of numeric constants is integers or fixed point numbers. If you write the number such as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125, 126, 127, 128, numbers are known as integers or fixed point numbers. Such numbers are known as integers or fixed point numbers, and there are rules for writing the integers or fixed point numbers in Fortran. Let us write down the rules for integers or fixed point numbers in Fortran. The first rule is the rules for writing integers in Fortran. See, what is the first rule? The numbers 0 through 9 are used for integers. When you want to write any integer, what you have to use? You have to use the numerals between 0 to 9. It is allowed. The first rule. The numerals 0 through 9 can be used to represent an integer. Actually, the numerals 0 through 9 must be used to represent an integer in Fortran language. First rule. Second rule, a comma, a decimal point, and other symbols are not allowed. When you are writing an integer in Fortran, use the numerals 0 through 9, but comma not allowed, decimal point not allowed, any other symbol is not allowed. You are not allowed to use a decimal point, a comma, or any other special symbol. This is the second rule that we have to remember while writing the integer in Fortran. The next one, plus and minus signs can be used. When you are writing integers, plus and minus signs can be used at the leftmost position of an integer. If this is integer, you are specifying in Fortran, plus sign, if you want to write plus sign, it will be here. It is the leftmost position of this integer. If you want to represent it by minus sign, it should be at the leftmost position of the integer. Okay, so positive and negative signs can be used at the leftmost position of an integer. Why negative sign is used? Negative sign is used at the leftmost position to represent a negative integer. When you want to represent a negative integer, use negative sign at the leftmost position of the integer. Here I have written only plus, nothing. It is similar. When you want to specify a positive integer, you can use plus sign at the leftmost position of the integer. The same statement is to be carried forward after plus. A plus sign can be used at the leftmost position of an integer if you want to represent a positive integer. Now, one more thing. When we are writing positive integers, many times, almost all times, we are not showing positive sign at the leftmost position. Actually, we are not showing any sign. This is also allowed. If you want to represent positive integer and if there is no sign at the leftmost position of this integer, Fortran will recognize this integer automatically as positive integer. So positive sign to be used at the leftmost position of an integer is optional. You may or may not use. If you use it, Fortran will recognize that integer as positive integer. If you do not write this positive sign, it means if there is no sign at the leftmost position of the integer, Fortran recognizes that integer again as a positive integer. Okay. Next, sixth rule. Blank space in an integer is meaningless. If you are writing integer this way, here you left a space. such blank spaces are meaningless. So there is no need to provide such blank spaces at the intermediate positions of the integer you are going to specify. Don't do this. Okay, so whenever you are specifying an integer in Fortran, remember these six rules. If you follow these six rules, the integer written in the Fortran will be a valid integer. If specification of integer number violates one of these rules, that integer will be invalid integer in Fortran language. For example, let me write here few examples of integers in Fortran. I have written few examples. -1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 6, 7, decimal point, 3, 4, 6, 7, 9, 8, 3,46,798, plus 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 3, 3, 6, 6, 7, 4. From these examples, these are all integers. Few integers are valid integers in Fortran and few are invalid integers. How to recognize valid integers and invalid integers? The integer which obeys the rules of writing an integer in Fortran will be valid integer, and the integer which does not obey the rules will be invalid. Let us come to these integers one by one. It uses only numerals. At the leftmost position, minus sign is there, so it is negative integer. It obeys all the rules, so it is valid integer in Fortran. Let us come to this. 3, 4, 6, 7 followed by a decimal point. In general algebra, in general writing, it is allowed. But in Fortran, it is not allowed because you are not allowed to use a decimal point. Therefore, this is invalid. Although algebraically, this is integer, this is valid integer. In Fortran, this integer is invalid. Now come to this. 3,46,798. In general, this is valid integer. In day-to-day transactions, if we write this way, this is not wrong. But if we write this in Fortran, it is wrong because a comma is not allowed. Come to this one. It uses numerals, okay. Positive sign is there at the leftmost position, okay. You have put a dollar here. Dollar is a special symbol. special symbols are not allowed in integers. So this is invalid. Minus sign. It is written at the rightmost position of the integer. Where it should be? It should be at the leftmost position of the integer. So this is also invalid. So only this integer is valid in Fortran. Remaining integers are invalid because decimal point is here not allowed, commas are used not allowed, special symbol used not allowed, minus sign placed at the rightmost position of the number, it is also not allowed. And therefore, from these examples, only first example is for valid integer in Fortran. Remaining are invalid integers in Fortran. Many things we have to talk regarding the constants. This is about the integer constant or fixed point number. After that, we have to talk about the real constant. Again, there are two categories of real constants. It will need at least one more lecture to complete the constants. So, I hope you understood the part I talked in this lecture. We shall continue the remaining part of this lecture in the coming lecture. Thank you.